Continuity is an easy property of complex functions. Continuity of u and v implies continuity of f. But what about differentiability? Would this work in the same way? Let us take a look at this video. So suppose we have a function f from domain to codomain, and we need some small ball with radius epsilon and center z0 is contained in the domain of f. And then we can define the derivative of f at z0. So what do we do? F prime z0, it's the same as in the real case. You take limit z to z0 and you have delta f divided by delta z, or fz minus z0 divided by z minus z0. And you can rewrite that a bit if you like by setting z equals z0 plus delta z, then z minus z0 becomes delta z, fz0 stays where it is, and fz becomes fz0 plus delta z. So that's another way to compute the derivative at z0. And then in general, for general z, we can set delta w equals f of z plus delta z minus f of z, and then we find f prime in some general z equals dw dz equals limit delta z to 0 of delta w over delta z, because then delta w is exactly the numerator over here. So now we have three ways to express the derivative in terms of fz minus fz0, in terms of a delta z, or in terms of delta w. They are all the same. So how do you compute the derivative? Well, let's do some examples. Here we have a function from c without 0 to c, f of z equals 1 over z. Well, we can use the definition and see what we get. So we compute delta w first, 1 over z plus delta z minus 1 over z. And we can simplify it, turn it into one fraction. Then this term becomes a z over z plus delta z, and this term becomes a z plus delta z over z times z plus delta z. And you see that if you take them together, the z's cancel out, and we get the minus delta z over z times z plus delta z. Then f prime of z, you have to take the limit of delta z to 0 of delta w divided by delta z. You see the delta z's cancel out. And you can just take the limit and you get a minus 1 over z squared. Well, probably won't surprise you, because it's analogous to the real case. And that's not so strange, because the definition is also very similar to the definition of the derivative of a real function. Do we have differences then with the real functions? Well, yes. Let's take a look at the second example, where we take f from c to c, and we take f of z equals z bar. Doesn't look too hard, right? Then for f prime of z, again, we take the limit delta z to 0 of delta w, so z plus delta z bar minus z bar. We see the z bars cancel out, and we get the limit z to 0 of delta z bar over delta z. But this limit does not exist, which means that the function is not differentiable at no point z at all. So here you see already a difference arising with the real functions. Function z bar doesn't look so bad, but still it's not differentiable. Let's look at the second example, f from c to c. F of z equals the norm of z squared equals z times z bar. Also doesn't seem that bad, right? Let's try to compute the derivative. So we get f at z plus delta z. So we get z plus delta z bar times z plus delta z minus f of z minus z bar. Divided by delta z, and if you work out the brackets, we find the z times z bar times z minus z bar times z cancel out. You have a z bar times delta z over delta z yields z bar. We have a delta z bar times z, and we have to divide by delta z to take the limit to 0, and delta z bar times delta z divided by delta z yields delta z bar. So, what do we get? Well, we cannot take this limit here, because again we have our delta z bar over delta z, and we've seen earlier that the limit doesn't exist. So this limit doesn't exist unless your z equals 0, because then this term cancels out. So f is only differentiable in 0, and in 0 the derivative becomes 0, because in 0 z bar is 0 as well, and we take a delta z to 0, so delta z bar equals 0 as well in the limit. So f of prime only exists in 0, and there f prime equals 0. So what do we see? Well, in example 3, we see that f can be differentiable at one point only, which is a bit odd if you compare to the real case. And we see in the third example, if you write f in terms of u and v, u equals x squared plus y squared and v equals 0, u and v are both differentiable. However, f of z is not differentiable at all. So you see that differentiability is definitely more complicated than continuity, because even though u and v are, well, in this case, infinitely many times differentiable, f of z does not need to be differentiable.